Welcome to an example on how to use the TI-84 graphing calculator to determine a data value given a probability involving a normal distribution. In this example, a class is given an exam, the distribution of the scores is normal, the mean is 82, and the standard deviation is 5. So because the mean is 82, we know mu equals 82, and because the standard deviation is 5, we know sigma equals 5. We're asked to determine the test score C such that the probability of a randomly selected student having a score greater than C is 25%. We can express this using this notation here, where we say the probability of X greater than C equals 0.25. Let's begin by modeling this distribution on the normal distribution curve shown here. Where because the mean equals 82, mean is here in the middle, and the horizontal axis is scaled by standard deviations. So to the right, we'd have 82 plus 5, which is equal to 87. 87 plus 5 is equal to 92. 82 plus 5 is equal to 97. To the left of 82, we have 82 minus 5, which equals 77. Then 77 minus 5 equals 72. And then 72 minus 5 is equal to 67. And because we know that 50% of the data is below the mean of 82, and 50% is above, and we also know that 34% is between 82 and 87, which is the mean and one standard deviation above the mean, the value of C we're looking for would be somewhere between 82 and 87. Let's approximate it to be here, where the probability that the test score is greater than C, or we can say to the right of C, is equal to 25%, or 0.25. To find this value of C on the T84, we'll be using the inverse norm feature, where once we access inverse norm, we enter the probability or area to the left, comma the mean, comma the standard deviation. So it's important to recognize that when we use the inverse norm feature, we must have the probability to the left, not to the right. In our case, though, notice how we have the probability to the right is 0.25, but to find this value of C on the 84, we need to find the probability to the left. So let's go ahead and shade to the left of C. So to find the probability to the left, we would take 100% and subtract 25%, or in decimal form, we would have 1 minus 0.25, which equals 0.75. So this is the probability that we must enter on the T84 in order to determine the value of C. And it should make sense that if there's a 25% chance of scoring above C, there would be a 75% chance of scoring below C. So going to the calculator, we'll press second vars for distribution, option 3 for inverse norm. If you have an older operating system, you won't see this screen, which I'll discuss in just a moment. But if you do have a newer operating system, the first thing they ask for is area, which in this case, this is not the standard normal distribution, because we don't have z-scores along the horizontal axis, so we can think of the area as the probability. If we did have the standard normal distribution, then the probability would be equal to the area under the curve. So the probability to the left is, again, 0.75. We can also enter 1 minus 0.25 if we want. Enter. The mean is 82. Enter. Standard deviation is 5. Enter. Enter again on paste. And again, if you have an older operating system, you'll have to remember the order that you enter the information is the probability, comma, the mean, comma, standard deviation. Close parenthesis, and then enter. So this is the value of C we're looking for. To one decimal place, we would say C is approximately 85.4. So we'll say C equals, or is approximately 85.4, which tells us the probability that X is greater than 85.4 is equal to, or approximately, 0.25, or 25%. So going back to our distribution, we just found the value of C here is approximately 85.4, where 25% of the scores are above 85.4, and 75% of the scores are below 85.4. So this is our answer, but before we go, I also want to talk about percentile. A percentile is a measure used to indicate the value below which a percentage of observations fall. For example, the 60th percentile is the value below which 60% of the observations can be found. So in this case, because 75% of the scores fall below 85.4, we can say the 75th percentile, in this case, corresponds to the test score of 85.4. I hope you found this helpful.